Hey guys, my name is Simsy and welcome back to some more The Elder Scrolls Total War. Now guys, first things first, I just want to thank each and every one of you who liked and commented and subscribed because of the last video. I think you guys absolutely smashed it. I think it's got like 1,500 views and over like 80 likes, which is crazy. It's only been up for like 2 days, and seeing as I have 850 subscribers and I made this channel last month, which I think is crazy. It's really good to see. So, enough sobby stuff. Let's get into playing the Elder Scrolls campaign. Now, as you do see here, it's not in Russian. So, I did have to wait a couple of days for the English patch to come out, because it came out and then it still didn't work. We had to wait for some scripts to come in and you just had to edit the scripts. But if you guys are still having problem, I will put in a Reddit post in the comment section down below and all the links. But there's a really good Reddit step-by-step instruction if you guys are still having problems with it. So let's get into the Tamriel Empire campaign, the Imperials and whatnot. So, now, in the Imperial City, Emperor Uriel, I still don't fucking say that name. Anyway, we can't take him out of the Imperial City. I have no idea why. He has, like, no movement points. Is it because he's old? He's 46. He's not too old. Obviously, not everything is translated. Most of it is still in Russian, but it's better than nothing, I guess. So, let's have a look through our commanders. We have Prince Gildol, Septon, Ebel Septon, Emon Septon, Joffrey. Yeah, I was actually right that was Joffrey. So there are the generals. Okay, so let's actually quickly recap where my armies are and what's happening in the Tamriel campaign. So we will be marching on this settlement in today's episode. There is a rather strong force of Draugr and Skeletons, the Necromancer. And then there's a captain of the guard just there. So we have Joffrey with a lot of awesome heavy legionary archers, heavy legionary swordsmen, and we got some Empire swordsmen and cavalry. And in the second army, it's not as good, but still a fair few. So we've got Joffrey commanding that along with Enman Septon, the prince, and Ebel Septon. So we've got two full stacks there pushing here. Now we have taken Pale Pass Ruins, which is a really good choke point for us if we do want to pivot and enter into Skyrim. I will get into diplomacy and what I plan to do soon, but we'll look at Cyrodiil and then we'll move on to these other settlements. So we do have a full, nearly a full stack here. I do have some forces moving up. We're going to pick off some of the rebel territories in and around here. That's probably the plan, realistically. We currently are besieging this rebel settlement here. We're going to be coming up against a lot of Akaviri swordsman there, so that's another good choke point. There's a lot of good choke points between settlements, mountain ranges and whatnot. We also have another army here about to push on some more necromancers, the undead faction. So let's have a quick look. So that's where all my armies are. So let's have a look at diplomacy. So we're currently, because this was all in Russian beforehand, so we are obviously the Tamriel Empire. We are Nine Divines cultist. Very untrustworthy, apparently. We are allies with the Kingdom of Daggerfall, the Clan of Crowned, the Kingdom of Wayrest, the Orcs, Forebears, the Kingdom of Skyrim. So we actually are allies with the Kingdom of Skyrim and one of the Great Houses. We are enemies with the undead. So who we are not at war with is the Old Merry Dominion, the Clans of the Black Marsh, two of the Khajiit factions, Great House Redoran, yeah. But the undead faction, the Daedric cultists, are at war with the majority. I did say I could push against Skyrim and take it all for myself, but I'm still not really too sure. Actually, I forgot to talk about these settlements, which I do seem to forget. I don't really know what I'm going to do. It looks like they could quite possibly attack me here, so I'm just going to keep these armies. But I think I might just wait until I've taken out most of the cultists and have most of the just the rebel territories around me, and then wait until someone declares war on me. We've got a pretty decent army here. We've taken most of this island. We have taken the entirety of this island. We'd start off with Raven Rock and Fort Frost Moth. We've taken Skalk Village and Tirisk. But that's pretty much it at the moment. Like I said, we're not at war with anyone. The victory conditions are to hold 60 regions, including the Imperial City. We have to defeat the Hordes of Oblivion and the Eldmeri Dominion, which are obviously over on the coast here. So we're going to still have to build up a pretty big fleet. I do believe they do have settlements down in here. But, obviously, we've got this army here pushing to get rid of more cultists. This army as well getting more rebel territory. So we have one, two, nearly three, nearly four, I'd say it's three. So we basically nearly have five stacks, which isn't too bad. But we're going to take this settlement away from the cultists. It's a pretty large army. Now, if I move my army here to attack the army, we should be pushed into a battle. Now, can we move him over here? No, we can't. I would rather fight this on the field. It is a 5-3 ratio. There's not many in that first army, of course. I reckon we can beat that on the field. Obviously, that's just Draugr and skeletons. We do have a lot of our heavy, Empire swordsmen. We do have a lot of heavy legionaries and heavy warriors. We also have a fair amount of troops as well. So, it's a 5-3. We do they outnumber us slightly. But nevertheless, let's fight this one on the battle map. If we do lose, we still have a full stack, but it's going to be a big one to say the least. So guys, if you are enjoying the Elder Scrolls Total War campaign, remember to leave a like. I would really much appreciate it. I do put a lot of effort into my videos, and a simple like really does go a long way in pushing my channel out there and exposing me to new subscribers, so it would be really much appreciated. But I really am enjoying this Elder Scrolls now that it's in English as well. It just makes it that little bit sweeter. So we are playing on the field. I would much rather play it in the field than the settlement. Okay, we got some. Okay, that's the pikemen. I don't think they even had any cavalry regardless. So what we're going to do is we're going to put, I'm just trying to think, what's the defense? 19. What's their defense? 17. Yeah, so we're definitely going to put these guys. What are these on? 11. Light legionary swordsmen. Spearmen on the flanks. Obviously, I haven't played this game overly that much, so I just need to quickly see what are the best units here. So, looking at the terrain, it'd be really cool point to like flank up on here. But the thing is, we don't know where the enemy is going to be deploying. So, we'll just go with the stock standard, and we'll move to account for the enemy. We are the Imperial Legion. We have crazy armor, so we do want to cluster quite a lot regardless, but here's the army if you're curious. So we want to put you guys there. So who's that leave left? Okay, we've got one more swords unit here. We'll group you and we'll put the lot of light and heavies there. Archers can be just pushed behind. Now, are these cavalry units? One is a cavalry unit. Joffrey has a blades unit. So we'll put the cavalry on the flanks here. I guess I could flank up around the top of the mountain. I don't see why not. Okay, so we'll put the cavalry and the general unit here. And the archers can sit just behind, obviously. We'll put the spearmen on the flanks. I won't deploy my pikemen. I might just keep them back here, seeing as the enemy doesn't have any cavalry. So, we're going to start the deployment. So, they are just sitting here. I'm trying to think what's the best way for us. Enemy reinforcements delayed. So, they've been delayed anyway. So, if we can defeat these units here, we'll be in a very favorable position. I just want to get everyone to halt for the minute. I'm going to get my cavalry to go with a direct charge into them, and I'll get my these guys to move up. But yeah, push everyone up in here. If we can get rid of these guys, the quicker the better. But we were quite lucky for the enemy to be delayed there. I imagine it's very much the same boat as Third Age and Westeros. The game can't handle that many reinforcements coming in, so they just don't do it. Okay, so we're charging here, 180 before the first initial charge. Man, you'd think, like, if skeletons hit the deck that hard, they would just absolutely shatter. Okay, I'm going to push these guys out. I'm going to move my cavalry unit just over to the top of the hill. My archers better not be firing, even though I told them to, because it's probably not a good idea. Yeah, we'll disable fire at will. And we'll get my units to come in there. We're going to get higher up. So, like, here, I guess. We need to get rid of these skeletons. For the Empire. I also apologize that I got the music muted, so you won't be able to hear the awesome music that you guys will be hearing if you play the mod. It's because of copyright on YouTube. I'd rather not risk it, because I have been actually having a problem with my sound and my sound cards and stuff like that. Even though if I mute the music, it still comes through, like, specifically. But if we can get rid of these guys before the enemy come in, I think we've won. I don't know if we take the settlement, but we'll soon find out. But a victory. We'll end it there. We lost one man. We deployed 2,665. The Captain Necromancer deployed 88. We killed 85. And obviously, I don't know why they're all called Necromancers. The Second Army didn't even deploy. Casualties inflicted. That Emperor Bodyguard unit did 50 in that. And 55 in that initial charge. The Empire Swordsman 5, 2, and 6. But a solid battle. Nothing really to be proud of. It was really nice and quick. I thought that other army would have deployed, to be honest. Just gonna have a quick sip of water. I apologize about that. So, we'll execute. So, no. It didn't. Or did it? Did it destroy the second army? No, it didn't at all. Okay, that was a complete waste. Okay, so the clans of the Black Marsh, the Kingdom of Enquina, Tribunal Temple, and the Great House of Redoron, or Radron. I don't really know these houses and how to pronounce them and whatnot. So, what we're going to do, we're going to start besieging, obviously. And I just hate medieval sieges that are like fortresses. Anything above a town, it just annoys the shit out of me because it just takes so fucking long. So we're gonna end the turn, and we will play that siege unless we've got a siege of our own here. This might be a little bit better against the rebels. Let's have a look at the results. Okay, so we are actually heavily outnumbered. I thought we would have had a better army. Oh, it's because of the Akaviri spearmen. What are they? Like, swordsmen coming at us. Yikes. Okay. Like I said, we're going to give it a red hot shot. It's a 2-3 ratio. We do outnumber them. We do have two generals here in Cairo. Or Cero. God, these names are hard to pronounce. I'm just going to give up, I think. So we're going to fight these rebels on the field. Hopefully we can get a victory. But let's have a read of the quotes, shall we? Tiber Septon does not keep those he does. He has no use for. Okay. A bit harsh. But it's going to be interesting to see how we go against these Akaviri guys. So, a lot of mushrooms. Okay, that's cool, I guess. So, we're going to quickly pause. We're going to drop all the siege equipment. And we're going to have to quickly form a line. So, what have we got to work with here? So we do have those one lot of legionaries, just a lot of basic town guards, swordsmen. Not the best, but you got to do what you got to do, I guess. We'll keep the spearmen on the flanks. But what's the spear? Yeah, the spear is actually nearly better than the town guard. So maybe I should make the front line with the spearmen armor-wise so they'll be able to hold. That's all I'm really thinking of. We'll put these guys here, I guess. And then so we'll deploy. We really want to kind of cluster and hold ourselves. So we'll group them and we'll put the archers just behind. We'll keep one lot of swordsman unit to protect the flanks ongoing. And then we'll put actually two swordsmen on the flanks here. We're going to go with a very Roman sort of tactic of battle. Hold the thick lines and hold them off as much as possible. So we've got my cavalry here. I might try push them to the flanks as much as possible. We'll keep the main general bodyguard here, but we'll push the town guard lancers to the flanks, so about here. We'll double time it, and we'll get the other bodyguard to hit on the flanks as well. So once they've come into us, I'm hoping we're out of range of missiles. I might need to double this formation a little bit more back. But everyone get into position as best you can, and hopefully we can be able to hold off against them. So where are they, the majority of them? Okay, that's not good. They're not being retextured, so that's disappointing, but what are you going to do? I was looking forward to them. Why aren't they retextured? You'd think they would be. Oh, well, because they just had such nice unit cards. They do have those Japanese flags at the back. Well, that Japanese style. Now, where are the majority of them pushing? To the left-hand side and to the right. We are out of range for the towers, but once we reform up, we should be right. I really like the the reskins of the heavy legionaries. I do apologize for that. My voice got a little bit caught up. Empire archers. Really nice looking. Okay, so are any of them breaching through the front gate? Start speeding this up. Slowly. We have to watch from this side, though. Because there's still a fair few units. So, for example, I might have to move this here. Just to cover that line. I'm going to push my cavalry further back. I don't want to push these guys too far out so they won't be able to respond, but I also don't want them too close in. Well, Seening's here. Are these guys going to push up? They did attack us. I don't want to get anywhere near to their ballista and stuff because it's just going to mince us. So it looks like they're reforming. But they have tails, so by the looks of it, I imagine they might be like Khajiits or Argonians or something. So the army is nearly in full effect here. So they are starting to charge. My archers aren't quite in range. So it looks like they are coming for the cavalry unit. We'll push around. But these guys should be able to hold. My archers are getting their shots off. I would be surprised if they killed anyone, though, in that. We'll quickly reform these guys. Or not. Okay, we're going to pull the cavalry out. And we're going to go for a counter charge once they get close enough. Or maybe we should not, because we've got spearmen. Maybe we should just brace for the impact. It's probably better. Because I forgot that I put my swordsman there. Okay, so, however, we need to engage these guys flanking. So we'll move my cavalry around. Especially that general unit. So we'll engage this, and we'll engage this. Where's that cavalry unit I had? Further here. So we'll push them a little bit closer. Archers, I still want you to be hitting in the cluster. But I will get them to attack. Because I want everyone involved. Okay, where is my cavalry unit? Okay, they're not... Why aren't they being quick enough? What the fuck? Get in. Okay, where's this other cavalry unit? Okay, get guys these guys to hit that. We'll use some general abilities. Okay, that cavalry unit seems to be free. So we'll push these guys up. How are they doing in the front line here? We've lost 7% of their 17, so we're in good standing at the moment. But that unit's been routed, which isn't good. They broke way too easy. It's these fucking mushrooms in the way. Well, they're heavy infantry. We should be able to, like... That charge basically did nothing. Hurt me more than anything. Okay. Fall over to this side. We need to hit these guys from behind in the center. If we can break this center, it might be able to help us a lot more. Okay, do we have units in reserve? We have one unit. We might as well get him in there to fix up that flank that fell. Yeah, hit that unit. My art... they're getting drawn out to hit this cavalry, and my archers are just rinsing them from behind. That's actually a really good tactic. Okay, so we've charged in here. Like I said, hopefully we can cause a rout, but I don't know if it's possible. Oh my god. I just realized I can move my cavalry into the town square and take it. Oh my fucking god, I didn't even realize. This happened in one of my Westeros campaigns. Okay, so I'm going to send this unit to double around and hold the gate. Because they have no cavalry in their army. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, double time into the town square while my army is distracting. If we can get a unit just to sit here, that would be superb. Come on, get there, double time it out. Okay, what else we got here? It's that unit. We'll push them around. We are surrounded here, which is unfortunate. But we only need to hold it off for not a very long amount of time. How is everyone doing? Okay, get the archers to hit that. Because the AI just maybe, might be that fucking stupid. Because now we've captured the gateway. So we'll get the general to hold it. I'm quite happy to sacrifice this lot of cavalry units. Just to hold them off at, like, here, for example. And if those... Okay, so they're, like... I don't know what they're doing. Are they just, like, trying to retreat back to the town square now? Okay, so we're in the town square. We have to hold this off for 4 minutes, and then we win. Oh, my God. We're currently looking at 23% of their 57. But these guys have been tremendously more powerful than what I originally thought. But especially running away like that, you'd think we'd better wreck them a little bit better. So we're currently just chilling in the town square with the general. And hopefully, with this cavalry unit, we'll be able to hold them off. Okay. Yeah, so they've only just started now. It's been a minute since we've been holding it. It's been a bloody battle, though. But it should be a good one. But now that the English version is out, I'm going to be uploading this as much as I can. Most likely every day. You definitely either get a Skyrim or a Tamriel episode per day. You'll definitely get a Elder Scrolls episode. Just depends how much time I have. If you guys don't already know, I run 2 full-time YouTube channels. I have this one, which I wholly and solely upload Total War. And then I have my main channel, which I, over the last at least 2 years, I've had that channel for like 3 years anyway. But I've been mainly uploading FIFA. I mainly upload FIFA. I do have my old Total War campaigns on there, as some of you may as well know. Okay, so we are being attacked here. But I do upload occasional games from time to time. GTA, Skyrim, for example. But I have been focusing on FIFA for that channel, and recently, about a month ago, I decided to make a Total War channel. Okay, so we'll get these guys here. We're going to have to get this cavalry unit to attack that Akaviri. Hopefully, Akatosh won't help them. Oh, right in the chest. -32 to -83. I am still disappointed that it looks kind of shitty still. I'm going to disable fire at will, because it looks like at the moment a lot more friendly fires happening than anything. I'm going to get my general unit to... actually, we'll just get him to hit this from behind. How's my general looking here? Still holding the line. My cavalry unit's taking on the Akaviri. And my main general unit here is about to charge into the rear. There were 47 before the first initial charge. Charge! Oh, unit routes. Jesus, I saw the notification. I thought, my God. We've just lost the general. What a heroic charge. Okay, we'll get him out of here. But this isn't even like a key settlement. This is just a random rebel settlement. 30 seconds remaining. 6 of the Akaviri swordsmen pushing in. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. But let's start speeding it up so we get the countdown. 20 more seconds. 37% of our allies killed to 95. Seeing that we were like tremendously outnumbered not to win, we really did sneak that in. It was a bit of a sucky way to win, but a victory is a victory. So guys, we deployed 2,158 and we lost 675. They deployed 1,200 and they lost 1,140. Looking at the here, the town guard killed 129. Another town guard unit killed 119. Town guard spear 111. So it actually proved out quite well to have those spearmen hold just because they had better armor. Obviously, that's probably not the best army I can field. You'd have to say that, obviously, the two full stacks in the north. But we'll have to see. So we're definitely going to sack because you get 2,400. But a nice strategical position between another mountain point. Enemy army routes, which is disappointing. But hey, what are you going to do? We're just going to quickly rally up. We'll build some roads and farms. Okay, end of turn report. The Tamriel Empire is dominating in military, along with everything else except financial, production, population, and overall. The undead actually control the financial. Most advanced faction is myself. And we have some attributes and whatnot which are in German, which isn't the best, but hey, what are you going to do? We have a lot of retraining as well and paved roads, which is good to see. We'll basically put money back into the economy, building just anything, just putting money back into the economy, essentially. I'd rather focus on the lands in Cyrazil, especially like, because obviously the empire's kind of split up here. We've got like two units here. We do control this island. Maybe if we can get some ports in, we might be able to get some nice trade. What's coming out of this island? Furs. It's 340 from trade. But we are going to end the episode here. My basic plan for this campaign is to try to pick off as many rebel settlements as possible. If we don't get attacked by a faction before then, we'll probably just have to go to war with the Old Merry Dominion, because it is a part of our victory conditions. How many regions do we need to control? 60. And we currently control 29. So we're probably going to need those settlements before we go to war with them. And especially with the Old Merry Dominion, they are on an island, like I said, so we're going to have to build up a pretty big fleet. And, well, most of our amphibious attacks will have to come from Anvil, I would imagine. But I do know for a fact that, obviously, in the Toggle Foe episode, we do know there's regions down here. So, like I said, we want to build up and take as many rebel and cultist settlements as possible just to boost our economy, blood our troops, and hopefully we can have a successful Tamriel Empire campaign. But guys, I'm going to end it here. Thank you very much for watching if you watched all the way through. I really do appreciate it. My name has been Simpsy. Remember to leave a like, and goodbye. Hey guys, my name is Simpsy, and welcome back to some more The Elder Scrolls Total War. Now guys, first things first, I just want to thank each and every one of you who liked and commented and subscribed because of the last video. I think you guys absolutely smashed it. I think it's got like over, 1,500 views, and over like 80 likes, which is crazy. It's only been up for like 2 days, and seeing as I have 850 subscribers, and I made this channel last month, which I think is crazy. It's really good to see. So, enough sobby stuff. Let's get into playing the Elder Scrolls campaign. Now, as you do see here, it's not in Russian, so I did have to wait a couple of days for the English patch to come out, because it came out, and then it still didn't work. We had to wait for some scripts to come in, and you just had to edit the scripts. But if you guys are still having problem, I will put in a Reddit post in the comment section down below, and all the links, but there's a really good Reddit step-by-step instruction if you guys are still having problems with it. So, let's get into the Tamriel Empire campaign, the Imperials and whatnot. So, now, in the Imperial City, Emperor Uriel, I still don't know how to fucking say that name. Anyway, we can't take him out of the Imperial City. I have no idea why. He has, like, no movement points. Is it because he's old? He's 46. He's not too old. Obviously, not everything is translated. Most of it is still in Russian, but it's better than nothing, I guess. So, let's have a look through our commanders. We have Prince Gildol, Septon, Ebel Septon, Emon Septon, Joffrey. Yeah, I was actually right that was Joffrey. So there are the generals. Okay, so let's actually quickly recap where my armies are and what's happening in the Tamriel campaign. So we will be marching on this settlement in today's episode. There is a rather strong force of Draugr and skeletons, the necromancer. And then there's a captain of the guard just there. So we have Joffrey with a lot of awesome heavy legionary archers, heavy legionary swordsmen, and we got some Empire swordsmen and cavalry. And in the second army, it's not as good, but still a fair few. So we've got Joffrey commanding that, along with Enman Septon, the prince, and Ebel Septon. So we've got two full stacks there pushing here. Now we have taken Pale Pass Ruins, which is a really good choke point for us if we do want to pivot and enter into Skyrim. I will get into diplomacy and what I plan to do soon, but we'll look at Cyrodiil and then we'll move on to these other settlements. So we do have a full, nearly a full stack here. I do have some forces moving up. We're going to pick off some of the rebel territories in and around here. That's probably the plan, realistically. We currently are besieging this rebel settlement here. We're going to be coming up against a lot of Akaviri swordsman there, so that's another good choke point. There's a lot of good choke points between settlements, mountain ranges and whatnot. We also have another army here about to push on some more necromancers, the undead faction. So let's have a quick look. So that's where all my armies are. So let's have a look at diplomacy. So we currently, because this was all in Russian beforehand, so we are obviously the Tamriel Empire. We are 9 divines cultist. Very untrustworthy, apparently. We are allies with the Kingdom of Daggerfall, the Clan of Crowned, the Kingdom of Wayrest, the Orcs, Forebears, the Kingdom of Skyrim. So we actually are allies with the Kingdom of Skyrim and one of the Great Houses. We are enemies with the undead. So who we are not at war with is the Old Merry Dominion, the Clans of the Black Marsh, two of the Khajiit factions, Great House Redoran, yeah. But the undead faction, the Daedric cultists, are at war with the majority. I did say I could push against Skyrim and take it all for myself, but I'm still not really too sure. Actually, I forgot to talk about these settlements, which I do seem to forget. I don't really know what I'm going to do. It looks like they could quite possibly attack me here, so I'm just going to keep these armies. But I think I might just wait until I've taken out most of the cultists and have most of the just the rebel territories around me, and then wait until someone declares war on me. We've got a pretty decent army here. We've taken most of this island. We have taken the entirety of this island. We'd start off with Raven Rock and Fort Frost Moth. We've taken Skalk Village and Tirisk. But that's pretty much it at the moment. Like I said, we're not at war with anyone. The victory conditions are to hold 60 regions, including the Imperial City. We have to defeat the Hordes of Oblivion and the Eld of One. I don't know if we take the settlement, but we'll soon find out. But a victory, we'll end it there. We lost one man. We deployed 2,665. The Captain Necromancer deployed 88. We killed 85. And obviously, I don't know why they're all called Necromancers. The Second Army didn't even deploy. Casualties inflicted, that Emperor Bodyguard unit did 50 in that, and 55 in that initial charge. The Empire Swordsman 5, 2, and 6. But a solid battle. Nothing really to be proud of. It was really nice and quick. I thought that other army would have deployed, to be honest. Just have a quick sip of water. I apologize about that. So, we'll execute. No, it didn't. Or did it? Did it destroy the second army? No, it didn't at all. Okay, that was a complete waste. Okay, so the clans of the Black Marsh, the Kingdom of Enquina, Tribunal Temple, and the Great House of Redoron, or Radron. I don't really know these houses and how to pronounce them and whatnot. So what we're going to do, we're going to start besieging, obviously. And I just hate medieval sieges that are like fortresses. Anything above a town, it just annoys the shit out of me because it just takes so fucking long. So we're going to end the turn. And we will play that siege, unless we've got a siege of our own here. This might be a little bit better against the rebels. Let's have a look at the results. Okay, so we are actually heavily outnumbered. I thought we would have had a better army. Oh, it's because of the Akaviri spearmen. What are they? Like, swordsmen coming at us. Yikes. Okay. Like I said, we're going to give it a red-hot shot. It's a 2-3 ratio. We do outnumber them. We do have two generals here in Cairo. Or Cero. God, these names are hard to pronounce. I'm just going to give up, I think. So we're going to fight these rebels on the field. Hopefully we can get a victory. But let's have a read of the quotes, shall we? Tiber Septon does not keep those he does. He has no use for. Okay. A bit harsh. But it's going to be interesting to see how we go against these Akaviri guys. So a lot of mushrooms. Okay, that's cool, I guess. So we're going to quickly pause. We're going to drop all the siege equipment, and we're going to have to quickly form a line. So what have we got to work with here? So we do have those one lot of legionaries, just a lot of basic town guards, swordsmen. Not the best, but you got to do what you're going to do, I guess. We'll keep the spearmen on the flanks. But what's the spear? Yeah, the spear is actually nearly better than the town guard. So maybe I should make the front line with the spearmen armor-wise so they'll be able to hold. That's all I'm really thinking of. We'll put these guys here, I guess. And then so we'll deploy. We really want to kind of cluster and hold ourselves. So we'll group them, and we'll put the archers just behind. We'll keep one lot of swordsman unit to protect the flanks ongoing, and then we'll put actually two swordsmen on the flanks here. We're going to go with a very Roman sort of tactic of battle. Hold the thick lines and hold them off as much as possible. So we got my cavalry here. I might try push them to the flanks as much as possible. We'll keep the main general bodyguard here, but we'll push the town guard lancers to the flanks. So about here, we'll double time it. And we'll get the other bodyguard to hit on the flanks as well. So once they've come into us, I'm hoping we're out of range of missiles. I might need to double this formation a little bit more back. But everyone get into position as best you can. And hopefully we can be able to hold off against them. So where are they, the majority of them? Okay, that's not good. They're not being retextured, so that's disappointing, but what are you going to do? I was looking forward to them. Why aren't they retextured? You'd think they would be. Oh, well, because they just had such nice unit cards. They do have those Japanese flags at the back. Well, the Japanese style. Now, where are the majority of them pushing? To the left-hand side and to the right. We are out of range for the towers, but once we reform up, we should be right. I really like the the reskins of the heavy legionaries. I do apologize for that. My voice got a little bit caught up. Empire archers. Really nice looking. Okay, so are any of them breaching through the front gate? Start speeding this up. Slowly. We're going to have to watch from this side, though. Because there's still a fair few units. So, for example, I might have to move this here. Just to cover that line. I'm going to push my cavalry further back. I don't want to push these guys too far out so they won't be able to respond, but I also don't want them too close in. Well, Seening's here. Are these guys going to push up? They did attack us. I don't want to get anywhere near to their ballista and stuff because it's just going to mince us. So it looks like they're reforming. But they have tails, so by the looks of it, I imagine they might be like Khajiits or Argonians or something. So the army is nearly in full effect here. So they are starting to charge. My archers aren't quite in range. So it looks like they are coming for the cavalry unit. We'll push around. But these guys should be able to hold. My archers are getting their shots off. I would be surprised if they killed anyone, though, in that. We'll quickly reform these guys. Or not. Okay, we're going to pull the cavalry out. And we're going to go for a counter charge once they get close enough. Or maybe we should not, because we've got spearmen. Maybe we should just brace for the impact. It's probably better. Because I forgot that I put my swordsman there. Okay, so, however, we need to engage these guys flanking. So we'll move my cavalry around. Especially that general unit. So we'll engage this, and we'll engage this. Where's that cavalry unit I had? Further here. So we'll push them a little bit closer. Archers, I still want you to be hitting in the cluster. But I will get them to attack. Because I want everyone involved. Okay, where is my cavalry unit? Okay, they're not... Why aren't they being quick enough? What the fuck? Get in. Okay, where's this other cavalry unit? Okay. Get guys these guys to hit that. We'll use some general abilities. Okay, that cavalry unit seems to be free. So we'll push these guys up. How are they doing in the front line here? We've lost 7% of their 17, so we're in good standing at the moment. But that unit's been routed, which isn't good. They broke way too easy. It's these fucking mushrooms in the way. Well, they're heavy infantry. We should be able to, like... That charge basically did nothing. It hurt me more than anything. Okay. Fall over to this side. We need to hit these guys from behind in the center. If we can break this center, it might be able to help us a lot more. Okay, do we have units in reserve? We have one unit. We might as well get him in there to fix up that flank that fell. Yeah, hit that unit. My arch... they're getting drawn out to hit this cavalry, and my archers are just rinsing them from behind. That's actually a really good tactic. Okay, so we've charged in here. Like I said, hopefully we can cause a rout, but I don't know if it's possible. Oh my god. I just realized I can move my cavalry into the town square and take it. Mary Dominion, which are obviously over on the coast here. So we're going to still have to build up a pretty big fleet. I do believe they do have settlements down in here. But obviously we've got this army here pushing to get rid of more cultists. This army as well getting more rebel territory. So we have 1, 2, nearly 3, nearly 4. I'd say that's 3. So we basically nearly have 5 stacks, which isn't too bad. But we're going to take this settlement away from the cultists. It's a pretty large army. Now, if I move my army here to attack the army, we should be pushed into a battle. Now, can we move him over here? No, we can't. I would rather fight this on the field. It is a 5-3 ratio. There's not many in that first army, of course. I reckon we can beat that on the field. Obviously, that's just Draugr and skeletons. We do have a lot of our heavy, Empire swordsmen. We do have a lot of heavy legionaries and heavy warriors. We also have a fair amount of troops as well. So, it's a 5-3. We do out... Oh, they outnumber us slightly. But nevertheless, let's fight this one on the battle map. If we do lose, we still have a full stack, but it's going to be a big one to say the least. So guys, if you are enjoying the Elder Scrolls Total War campaign, remember to leave a like. I would really much appreciate it. I do put a lot of effort into my videos, and a simple like really does go a long way in pushing my channel out there and exposing me to new subscribers, so it would be really much appreciated. But I really am enjoying this Elder Scrolls now that it's in English as well. It just makes it that little bit sweeter. So we are playing on the field. I would much rather play it in the field than the settlement. Okay, we got some... Okay, that's the pikemen. I don't think they even had any cavalry regardless. So what we're going to do is we're going to put... I'm just trying to think, what's the defense? 19. What's their defense? 17. Yeah, so we're definitely going to put these guys. What are these on? 11. Light legionary swordsmen. Spearmen on the flanks. Obviously, I haven't played this game overly that much, so I just need to quickly see what are the best units here. So, looking at the terrain, it'd be really cool point to like flank up on here. But the thing is, we don't know where the enemy is going to be deploying. So, we'll just go with the stock standard, and we'll move to account for the enemy. We are the Imperial Legion. We have crazy armor, so we do want to cluster quite a lot regardless, but here's the army if you're curious. So we want to put you guys there. So who's that leave left? Okay, we've got one more swords unit here. We'll group you and we'll put the lot of light and heavies there. Archers can be just pushed behind. Now, are these cavalry units? One is a cavalry unit. Joffrey has a blades unit. So we'll put the cavalry on the flanks here. I guess I could flank up around the top of the mountain. I don't see why not. Okay, so we'll put the cavalry and the general unit here. And the archers can sit just behind, obviously. We'll put the spearmen on the flanks. I won't deploy my pikemen. I might just keep them back here, seeing as the enemy doesn't have any cavalry. So we're going to start the deployment. So they are just sitting here. I'm trying to think what's the best way for us. Enemy reinforcements delayed. So they're being delayed anyway. So if we can defeat these units here, we'll be in a very favorable position. I just want to get everyone to halt for the minute. I'm going to get my cavalry to go with a direct charge into them. And I'll get my these guys to move up. But yeah, push everyone up in here. If we can get rid of these guys, the quicker the better. But we were quite lucky for the enemy to be delayed there. I imagine it's very much the same boat as Third Age and Westeros. The game can't handle that many reinforcements coming in. So they just don't do it. Okay, so we're charging here. 180 before the first initial charge. Man, you'd think like if skeletons hit the deck that hard, they would just absolutely shatter. Okay, we're going to push these guys out. I'm going to move my cavalry unit just over to the top of the hill. My archers better not be firing, even though I told them to. Because it's probably not a good idea. Yeah, we'll disable fire at will. And we'll get my units to come in there. We're going to get higher up. So like here, I guess. We need to get rid of these skeletons. For the Empire. I also apologize that I've got the music muted. So you won't be able to hear the awesome music that you guys will be hearing if you play the mod. It's because of copyright on YouTube. I'd rather not risk it. Because I have been actually having a problem with my sound and my sound cards and stuff like that. Even though if I mute the music, it still comes through, like specifically. But if we can get rid of these guys before the enemy come in, I think we've... Oh my fucking god, I didn't even realize. This happened in one of my Westeros campaigns. Okay, so I'm going to send this unit to double around and hold the gate. Because they have no cavalry in their army. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, double time into the town square while my army is distracting. If we can get a unit just to sit here, that would be superb. Come on, get there, double time it out. Okay, what else have we got here? It's that unit. We'll push them around. We are surrounded here, which is unfortunate. But we only need to hold it off for not a very long amount of time. How is everyone doing? Okay, get the archers to hit that. Because the AI just might be that fucking stupid. Because now we've captured the gateway. So we'll get the general to hold it. I'm quite happy to sacrifice this lot of cavalry units. Just to hold them off at, like, here, for example. And if those... Okay, so they're like... I don't know what they're doing. Are they just, like, trying to retreat back to the town square now? Okay, so we're in the town square. We have to hold this off for 4 minutes, and then we win. Oh, my God. We're currently looking at 23% of their 57. But these guys have been tremendously more powerful than what I originally thought. But especially running running away like that, you'd think we'd better wreck them a little bit better. So we're currently just chilling in the town square with the general. And hopefully, with this cavalry unit, we'll be able to hold them off. Okay. Yeah, so they've only just started now. It's been a minute since we've been holding it. It's been a bloody battle, though. But it should be a good one. But now that the English version is out, I'm going to be uploading this as much as I can. Most likely every day. You'll definitely either get a Skyrim or a Tamriel episode per day. You'll definitely get a Elder Scrolls episode. Just depends how much time I have. If you guys don't already know, I run two full-time YouTube channels. I have this one, which I wholly and solely upload Total War. And then I have my main channel, which I, over the last at least 2 years, I've had that channel for like 3 years anyway. But I've been mainly uploading FIFA. I mainly upload FIFA. I do have my old Total War campaigns on there, as some of you may as well know. Okay, so we are being attacked here, but I do upload occasional games from time to time. GTA, Skyrim, for example. But I have been focusing on FIFA for that channel, and recently, about a month ago, I decided to make a Total War channel. Okay, so we'll get these guys here. We're gonna have to get this cavalry unit to attack that Akaviri. Hopefully, Akatosh won't help them. Oh, right in the chest. -32 to -83. I am still disappointed that it looks kind of shitty still. I'm gonna disable fire at will, because it looks like at the moment a lot more friendly fires happening than anything. I'm gonna get my general unit to we'll just get him to hit this from behind. How's my general looking here? Still holding the line. My cavalry units taking on the Akaviri, and my main general unit here is about to charge into the rear. There were 47 before the first initial charge. Charge! Oh, unit routes. Jesus, I saw the notification. I thought, my God. We've just lost the general. What a heroic charge. Okay, we'll get him out of here. But this isn't even like a key settlement. This is just a random rebel settlement. 30 seconds remaining. 6 of the Akaviri swordsman pushing in. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. But let's start speeding it up so we get the countdown. 20 more seconds. 37% of our allies killed to 95. Seeing that we were like tremendously outnumbered not to win, we really did sneak that in. It was a bit of a sucky way to win. But a victory is a victory. So guys, we deployed 2,158 and we lost 675.